Welcome back students. Today we shall start the seventh session where we are going to discuss about the sources of investment information. The sources of investment information is nothing but the different ways from where we can get the information relating to investment. So where is avenues relating to investment can be just sought to this particular topic. Objectives of the chapter, this remains, as I told you, same for all the 10 sessions. So now we are going to discuss about the session outcome. At the end of this session, you will be able to understand or state the sources of investment information, means all the different ways from where or different sources, channels from where you can get the investment information. So let us go for that. Sources of investment information. The sources of investment information are broadly classified into 5: international affairs, national affairs, industry information, company information, and stock market information. So sources of investment information, first of all, let me just tell you a few things. An investor must be very much aware, and he should have an adequate knowledge about the investment alternatives and markets before making any kind of investment. That is very important, whether he is making an investment in national securities or international securities or some company securities. He has to be very careful and he has to get proper information from different sources which are available. And of course, today there is something like online, everything is available online. And but in using that, is you have to be very precautionary and you have to be very careful, because there are so many people who will provide you false information. So you have to be very careful about which information you are going to use and you are going to plan according to that particular information. So generally, when we talk about sources of information, we have the various sources like newspapers, investment diaries, magazines, in journals, RBI bulletins, websites, stock market information, etc. But when we go by one by one, we have different sources. So generally, these are, as I told you, divided into different parts, that is international affairs. When we talk of international affairs, you just go to the internet, you will get different information from there. Generally, these newspapers and TV news programs will be there relating to international affairs. So we generally have a magazine called as Wall Street Journal and CNN-FN, which gives you information about international affairs. And there are certain business publications like Business Week, Forbes, Fortune, Consumer Reports, which will give you information. And there are Federal Reserve bulletins, which will give you information. And there are different prospectus of different companies at the international level, which will give you information. And there is something like Standard & Poor's 500 Stock Index or Dow Jones Industrial Information, which will give you information on international affairs. And then you have newsletters and publications from financial people at international level. So these all information, it's not like you will get at home. You have to go search for it and get it from them. And you will be having some international brokers. They will give you information. And before you could invest in any security, you should first know what are the relationship of that particular nation with our nation and how the affairs, whatever you carry on, will affect, will have an impact. So that is the most basic thing what an organization has to take into, an individual or organization has to take into consideration. Okay, students, so that is international level. It is between when you go for investing in other country securities, other country bonds, other country company bonds, this question comes, and at that time you have to be quite careful and you have to take a decision based on the information what you collect, and the information what you collect should be accurate and it should be very much perfect. You should not go by the talks of others. So students, when we go for national affairs, it is nothing but the economic conditions. It is up in within the nation. And when we go for, you go for investing in the national market, it is like you have different sources of information. So here you have to, I'll just tell you, there are so many ways. As I told you in the previous, like international affairs, you have newspapers, bulletins, magazines, journals. And here we have this RBI bulletin, and many companies will release their data. And basically here, if you want to know, there are some 7 websites which you can just go for browsing if you want to go for investment. The first, like, I'll just brief you out that we have Money Control, we have Screener, Investing.com, Economic Times Market, Live Mint, and the 4 most important, the National Stock Exchange and the Bombay Stock Exchange, what we have, NSE India and BSE India, where you will get almost all the information relating to different industries and different companies. And apart from that, you can have a copy of, you can have a list of certain Google searchers, Yahoo, Rediff, and there's something called as Market Mojo, Investello, Trendline. And today the most important, like as I told you in the previous one, if you go to a website, you search for it, once you search, you keep on getting notifications relating to that. So students, when we go for industry information, we take industry as a whole. Industry is nothing but a particular industry where different companies are operating. Say for example, if I go for mobile industry, it consists of all industries. There are unlimited industries, companies in that industry. Now if I go for a mobile industry, you can just go for you have Samsung, you have Apple iPhone, you have OnePlus, you have whatnot, Oppo, you have Vivo. I think we have a large list of industries in that, and that information you have to extract from various sources, and you have to go through that, and then you have to invest in that particular. You have software industries, you have automobile industry, you have fast moving consumer goods industries, you have textile industry. So you have to choose a particular industry, and then you have to go for investing in that. So what I want to tell here is, apart from going for all those informations, whatever are available on the internet or relating to the company, the investor has to be very careful about the information what he gets from different sources, and he has to correlate that information with the existing position of the company or the organization, and only then he has to go for purchasing it. And be very careful about this websites. There are so many websites where you can exchange opinions, you can go for about the stocks and investing, and but be very careful about this stock manipulators. They will post false news, and many times they will give over optimistic opinion about a company or a industry. And many times what happens, you should know your source from where you are getting, and you have to be very careful about this pump and dump. And many people, they'll hype the stock and sell out on the inflated prices, and many times they'll give an advertisement, get rich quick. They try to sell some securities based on that concept, and they try to trap you, and then that money will not come back to you. So that you have to be very careful about. And next one is company information. Here when we go for the company, you get various information from different companies. We have so many general business periodicals will be there, trade publications will be there, magazines will be there. So what happens, whichever you go for, you have to be very careful about that. And many companies will give information or news, news in the newspaper, and there will be, when you go for the company website itself, there will be so many displays, so many advertisements will come, and you can just go for that to get the information about different securities or bonds. And stock market information, when we go for stock market, as I told you, we have BSE, NSE, they have their regular information publications, and you can just go take the information through that. And when we just talk about this BSE or the stock market, so many brokers, so many bulls and bears will be there in the industry, and they will just reveal you the information. And we have so many business periodicals which will give you information, and government publications also will give you information. And whenever government issues bonds or infrastructure bonds and all this, that will be advertised, and you should have a constant track of it. And I think every place there will be some stock exchange office, some brokers will be there. Just you contact them, they will give you a good idea, but you have to go for a reliable source. That is very important for any investor, and you have to be very careful about the source from where you are getting the information. And now a small just a glimpse of the next topic in this session. I'll just go to that. So dear students, now we will discuss about the factors affecting investment management. This is nothing but the factors to be considered while taking an investment decision or while making an investment. It is rightly told that investment is an art. It is said that investment is an art. It so happens that many people invest without knowing what they are doing, and only a few people understand the art of investing money. And when you go for investing in a appropriate way, you have to consider certain factors. So it is many times told by in many investment decisions that you should not lay the eggs in single basket. You have to lay the eggs in different baskets, so that whenever you go for incurring any loss, it will not you affect you to a very great extent. So this happens when, say for example, you are having some 5 lakh rupees. Don't invest all the 5 lakh rupees in shares. You can invest a part of it in debentures, some in bonds, some in shares, some in mutual funds, some in UTI, something. In that way, it can be allocated. And some you can purchase gold, you can just keep it, so that whenever there is a loss, you don't affect much. So one a loss will be in one particular field, the other field will give you the return. So the factors to be considered while making an investment decision are: first one is rate of interest. Rate of return is nothing but the return on investment. So an individual may have various investments. As I told you, he may invest in high risk equity investments, or he may go for fixed interest bearing securities, or he may go for a portfolio which consists of many other alternatives, and he may go for readjusting the investments depending on the rate from each of the investment. So here the rate of return is very important for any individual, because the investment itself is made in order to get some benefit or some return out of that, and every investor wants to get the highest return out of the investment whatever they make. The second one is inflation. What is inflation? It is nothing but the boom in the economy, wherein the rate of the prices of all commodities will be very higher. So when you go for investment, you have to see that the investment whatever you make, it has to beat the inflation rate at the time when you make the investment, and at the time when you are going to get the return. And many times it happens that in case of inflation, whenever this is very much problematic for those investors who depend purely on their return for survival. So at the time the investor has to be a little careful while investing. Next one is liquidity. What is liquidity? It is the ability of the funds to be converted into cash easily without loss of time and money. So what happens here? You should, whatever investment you make, in case of emergency, it should be liquidated easily. And also this depends on two conditions. One is the requirement of money by you, and the second one is when you want to change the investment strategy, it should be able to be liquidated. Only then it can be convenient for you. Otherwise, if you invest in real estate, it cannot be liquidated very easily. If you purchase gold at the same time, it can be sold very easily. If you purchase shares, you can sell easily. If you purchase bonds, it is not easy to sell, to be sold. So that has to be taken into consideration. If you purchase an NSE bond, what happens? That can be redeemed only after a period of 5 years or 10 years. In between, if you want to go for, you have to do it for a discount, which may be a loss for you. The next point is tax benefits. So most of the individuals invest in order to get advantage of the tax. If you don't take a proper wise decision, the tax can wipe away the return on investment whatever you get. Okay, so here there are so many options in the income tax law, different sections which will give you lot of benefits, or many tax benefits you can use that in order to get maximum out of that. So first thing is you have to understand the tax laws of the land in which you are staying, and you have to understand the benefits so that you get best out of the rest. The next one is frequency of return. That is, this is basically required for those individuals who depend on the return for their survival, or some many times it also depends on the individual's desire to reinvest the money. See, sometimes you want to reinvest. At that time, if you get frequent return, you use some money for your requirements and some amount can be used for reinvesting in the future. So that has to be taken care of. And say if you are aiming at capitalization, you can take some shares and you can sell it after a long period of time wherein your money will be accumulated. But if you want to go for reinvesting and even for using for your day-to-day purpose, at that time you have to consider such kind of securities which will give you return frequently and on time. Okay students, so these are few factors which has to be considered while going for a investment decision. Okay students, next we have the multiple choice questions. Let us go for that. So the first multiple choice question is, students, return ROI denotes return on investment, return on interest, return on income, risk on investment. It is return on investment. Okay. So the next sub question, multiple choice question what we have is, which of the following is known as indirect investment alternative? Cash, equity shares, pension fund, and TIX. It is pension fund. The next one, the financial meaning of investment means money put in for productive use, purchase of second-hand instruments, pension benefits, dividends. It is productive use. Here we have, speculation can be distinguished from investment based on financing meaning, economic meaning, risk, tax. So speculation is different from investment only on the basis of risk. Investment professionals whose jobs may depend on their performance relative to the market are the registered representatives, security analysts, investment bankers, portfolio managers. It is security analysts. So here, students, okay students, these are the references what we have. You can just go through certain books, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.